Quadratic Equations, Factoring, Level 5. In the previous video, we started solving quadratic equations of the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Recall that we went over two examples, one where both the coefficients b and c were positive, and one where b was negative and c was positive. In order to factor quadratic trinomials, we had to find integer values for r and s to generate the linear factors of the quadratic equation. In the case where both the values of b and c were positive, we had to find two positive factors of c that add up to b. In the case where b was negative and c was positive, we had to find two negative factors of c that add up to negative b. In this video, we will go over the case when b is positive and c is negative, and the case when b is negative and c is negative. Lastly, we will go over an example where the quadratic trinomial is not factorable over the integers. Let's go ahead and go over an example where the coefficient b is negative and the coefficient in c is negative. Solve the equation x squared minus x minus 20 equals 0. First step is to make sure the quadratic equation is in standard form. This step has been taken care for us. Next, notice that we are dealing with a quadratic trinomial where the value of a is equal to 1. So let's go ahead and find out if we can solve this equation by factoring. Remember, not all quadratic trinomials can be solved by factoring, so we need to check if factoring is the way to go. We start by setting up our table, listing the factors of c, whose product equals negative 20. When dealing with quadratic trinomials, whose constant coefficient is a negative number, r and s will always have opposite signs. One will be positive and the other will be negative. As a consequence, not only do we need to list all factors of c, but also the various combinations for which a negative sign can be assigned to each pair. So let's go ahead and start with the first pair, positive 1 times negative 20. Notice that in order to obtain negative 20, one factor has to be positive and the other factor has to be negative. In the same manner, negative 20 can also be obtained by switching the signs. So the second pair is negative 1 times positive 20. Because the value of c is negative, we need to consider both pairs. Because negative 20 can be obtained in two different ways, either 1 or 20 has to be negative. So we go ahead and list both combinations. Moving along, we go ahead and find the rest of the pairs. The next pair is 2 times negative 10, and negative 2 times positive 10, followed by positive 4 times negative 5, and lastly negative 4 times positive 5. Next step is to find the sum of the factors. For the first pair, their sum equals negative 19. The sum of the next pair add up to positive 19. The next pair add up to negative 8. The one after that add up to positive 8. The fifth pair add up to negative 1. And the last pair add up to positive 1. Having found all the pairs and sums, we go ahead and scan the list looking for the factors whose product equals negative 20 and sum equals negative 1. Notice that the fifth row satisfies both conditions, so this quadratic trinomial is factorable. The values for r and s are positive 4 and negative 5 respectively. So we go ahead and factor this expression using these values. Doing that, we obtain the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity x minus 5 equals 0. Next, we go ahead and solve the quadratic equation by applying the zero product property to each of the factors. Doing that and solving for x, we obtain x equals negative 4 as one solution and x equals 5 as a second solution. The key idea you need to take away from this problem is the fact that one factor had to be positive and the other factor had to be negative. So we need to list all the combinations of factors where at least one of them is negative and the other is positive. Remember, this occurs whenever the value of the constant c is negative and that of b is negative. All right, let's go ahead and try the next problem. Solve the equation x squared plus 29x minus 30 equals 0. Notice that this type of quadratic equation has a positive coefficient for b and a negative coefficient for c. This combination of coefficients also requires one positive factor, similarly like the previous example. Alright, so first step is to write the quadratic equation in standard form and set 0 as one side of the equation. For this example, both steps have been taken care for us. Next, we go ahead and try to factor the quadratic trinomial. So we start by creating our table and start listing the factors of negative 30, remembering to list all the combinations that include a positive factor and a negative factor. So we start with the first pair, 1 times negative 30. Then we switch the signs and obtain negative 1 times 30 as the second pair. Next we have 2 times negative 15, followed by negative 2 times 15, then 3 times negative 10, and negative 3 times positive 10. Lastly, we have 5 times negative 6, and negative 5 times positive 6. So we have 8 distinct pairs. Next, we go ahead and find the sum of each pair. Doing that, we obtain negative 29, 29, negative 13, 13, negative 7, 7, negative 1, and 1. Next, we scan each row looking for the factors whose product equals negative 30 and sum equals 29. The factors that satisfy both conditions are located in the second row, negative 1 and positive 30. So these two factors represent R and S, so we go ahead and substitute them to obtain the factored form of this quadratic equation, specifically the quantity x minus 1 times the quantity x plus 30. The final step is to apply the zero product property to each factor and solve for x. Doing that, we obtain x equals 1 as one solution, and x equals negative 30 as a second solution. In this example, the coefficient on the linear term was positive, and the coefficient on the constant term was negative. When you have this combination of coefficients, one of our factors must be positive, and one of them must be negative. To sum up, there are 4 distinct cases you will encounter when dealing with quadratic trinomials of the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Whenever the constant term is positive, both factors r and s will have the same sign. Both will be positive if b is positive, and both will be negative if b is negative. If the constant c is negative, then the factors will have opposite signs. One will be positive and one will be negative, regardless if b is negative or positive. These are the 4 cases that you will encounter when dealing with quadratic trinomials that are factorable over the integers. Recall that not all quadratic trinomials are factorable over the integers. In general, a polynomial that cannot be expressed as a product of polynomials, in other words, as factors of lower degree, is said to be irreducible. An irreducible polynomial with integral coefficients whose greatest monomial factor is 1 is referred to as a prime polynomial. Let's go over an example to illustrate this. Solve the equation x squared minus 10x plus 14 equals 0. Alright, we are face to face with a quadratic trinomial. Let's see if we can factor this expression. Notice that the constant b is negative and c is positive. This means that our potential factors will both be negative, so we find all the negative factors of positive 14. They are negative 1 times negative 14 and negative 2 times negative 7. The sum of the first pair equals negative 15, and the sum of the second pair add up to negative 9. Notice that none of the factors add up to the middle term, negative 10. This quadratic trinomial is an example of an irreducible polynomial, and is not factorable over the integers. In addition, the greatest monomial factor is 1, meaning every single term has 1 as its GCF. This means that this particular polynomial is prime. So we can't factor it over the integers. We need to find another way to solve this equation. We will come back and solve this equation with a different technique in a future video. For now, this equation is not factorable over the integers, but can be solved nonetheless. Many students think that if a polynomial is prime, it has no solution. This is completely wrong. A prime polynomial means that we need to solve it using a different technique. So don't assume that it has no solution if you were unsuccessful factoring the equation. Alright, in our next video, we will go over slightly more challenging examples.